Chief Medical Officer Dr. Sharon Belmar-George explains that the most recently diagnosed COVID-19 cases are individuals who had been seen at the community level at one of the respiratory clinics. The individuals, she says, were all placed in quarantine after being assessed and tested, and after receiving their results, were all placed in isolation. Meanwhile, the total number of COVID-19-related deaths also continued to rise, with three more individuals passing away. The two elderly men and one elderly woman were all registered as having underlying health conditions.
Death number 20 is a 69-year-old male from the ancillary district with underlying medical conditions. He was admitted on January 22, 2021, and was in critical care, and he passed away on February 9, 2021. Death number 21 is an 85-year-old female from the Babono district with underlying medical conditions. She was admitted into care on January 19, 2021 and passed away on February 8, 2021. Death number 22 is a 63-year-old male from the Castries district with underlying medical conditions. This individual was admitted into care on February 1, 2021 and passed away on February 7, 2021.
Noting the high number of COVID cases, the inadequacy of some homes to give the required isolation, as well as continued breaches by individuals, the Ministry of Health has, with immediate effect, ceased all home isolation. This change to the ministry's isolation policy comes just over a month after it had gone the way of home isolation for mild cases. This option was chosen after the number of COVID patients surpassed bed numbers at the respiratory hospital.
This change now means that mild cases are being placed within hotel sites, and the moderate to severe cases continue to be cared for within the National Respiratory Hospital. This allows for a greater degree of vigilance in the management of the milder COVID-19 cases, given home isolation cannot be effectively conducted for some individuals who are in care. These changes have been made primarily to protect the health and safety of all, not only people diagnosed with the virus. It is expected that this new model will support the efforts to contain the virus and will allow for more focused care being delivered to all our patients as their period of infection is being managed.
The total number of active COVID-19 cases on island now exceeds 700. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.